In this presentation, we'll continue to discuss about classification of attributes, guiding us in better understanding of entity modeling. In the previous topic, we discussed about the classification of attributes in simple and composite attributes based on the structure of the values for the attribute. In this topic, we look at how many values the attribute may have, and we'll classify them in single value for a single value or multi-value for several values. Let us consider the following example that models brief information about a book as it appears on the cover. The name of the entity is book, and the image shows an entity instance, an example of a book. The attribute shown on the cover includes the title of the book, some books may have a subtitle, and the authors. We'll discuss about each of these attributes. A book has a single title. For instance, the book provided as example has the title Knowledge Engineering, Building Cognitive Assistants for Evidence-Based Reasoning. Because the attribute has always a single value, it is named single value attribute. A book has one or more authors, so the attribute author may have a single value, but may also have two or more values. In our case, the book has four authors, Tecuci, Marcu, Boicu, and Sham. Because the attribute may have multiple values, is named multi-value attribute. In the following, we'll discuss in more details about each of these types of attributes. What is a single value attribute? A single value attribute is an attribute that has at most one value for a given entity instance. It is usually storing values of elementary type of data like numbers, dates, or text with no structure. Let us consider a few examples of single value attributes. The cost of a car, for instance, $32,497, is a single value attribute because a given car has a single cost. The title of a book, for instance, Databases, is another single value attribute because a book has a single title. The name of a city, for instance, Fairfax, is a single value attribute for the entity city because, again, a city has a single name. The height of a mountain, for instance, 5,367 feet, is a single value attribute because the mountain has a single height. The color of a paint, for instance blue, is a single value attribute because the paint has a single color. In all of these examples, the attribute has at most one value and represents an elementary type of data, number of text. What is a multi-value attribute? A multi-value attribute is an attribute that may have two or more values for some entity instances. The value must have the same meaning, represent the same property for the entity. For this reason, they also will be of the same type of data. Let us consider a few examples of multi-value attributes. The phone number of a person is a multi-value attribute because a person may have several phone numbers, for instance, home phone, cell phone, office phone. Another example is the author of a book because a book may have multiple authors. The email of a person is another example of a multi-value attribute as a person may have several emails. The prerequisite courses of a given course is another example of multi-value attribute, as a course may have several other courses as prerequisites. In all these examples, the multi-value attribute may have several values of the same type. When to divide a multi-value attribute? This is an easy question. Almost always, we like to divide a multi-value attribute. This is because an undivided multi-value attribute is hard to process and maintain. For instance, to add a new value, delete a value, or just process the values one by one will require you to do text processing to extract the individual values from a list stored as a single text. Let us consider an example. The email address of a person. If a person has two or more email addresses, we'll store them separated by comma as a single text value. If you want to send an email to each of the addresses, you will need to extract each email address by searching for the comma in the value of the attribute. Even more complicated is to delete an email because you will need to identify the comma before it, if any, the comma after it, if any, and delete the email including one of the commas. In the next module, we'll discuss two ways to divide a multi-value attribute in single-value attributes.